Welcome back friends, my name is Deepak More. You are watching my YouTube channel, theindianoptions.com. Today we are going to discuss an advanced strategies that is called as vertical spread. Now, before going into this strategy, I'm assuming that you know options basics, you have learned basic strategies which we have discussed in section 4. And you have also seen all the videos in trading behavior. You know what is option chain, and you know what is call buy, put buy, call sell, put sell, all those strategies in and out. And so now this is a very advanced strategies, and unless you have a very, very deep basic understandings, I'm not really suggesting that you should really try to implement these strategies. Because while on one hand you might make some money, but there is also a chance that you might lose money. So extreme caution has to be exercised when using these advanced strategies. These strategies are usually used by institutional traders who are the traders for really 10 years, 20 years, or maybe, you know, really long time. So I really think that before going into this advanced strategies, you should really be hands-on on the basic strategies. You should know it in and out. Only then try to attempt this. Okay, so in this section we are going to discuss four different strategies, and this is the first strategy. And within one strategy, we have like four or five different flavors that can be implemented. So though we are doing only four videos on these basic advanced four strategies, but every strategy has four or five different variations that you can implement. So it becomes like 20 more strategies which you can choose from, basically, right? So so now there would be an extra challenge for you. That we have we have learned around seven strategies in the basic sections, plus in this section we are going to learn more 13 or 14 strategies. So overall there would be like a set of 20 to 22 strategies from which you can choose for your daily trading. And I think so, if you are able to master all these 12 strategies or so, that is more than sufficient for your whole options trading career, basically. So just make sure that you know this in and out. Just practice it along, practice with just one lot each, and then see how you are comfortable with that before going into a larger scale of lots or something. Okay, now going back to the next slide. Now I'm assuming that you know option chain, and you know what options to look for, and how do we read the option chain, and what is the call side, what is the put side, and what is the strike prices, and all these are the basic information which we have already discussed in all the previous videos. So I'm not going to go into a lot of details. I'm just assuming that you know all these basics, and I'm moving forward with this new knowledge. Okay. Now the first strategy is bull call spread. Now what is vertical spread? First of all, in vertical spread what happens is you buy one either on the call side or on the put side, you buy one lot at the lower strike price and you sell one lot at the higher strike price, and then if the market stays in middle, then you will make profit or loss or something. So we'll go discuss that in later. But in this vertical spread, there are always, it is a two leg strategy. So you always buy one and sell one, or always buy two or sell two or something like that. Okay. Now going into this next slide. Now here I'm taking an example of call side vertical spread. So that's why it is called as bull call spread. Okay. Now in this, what happens is this bull call spread is an option strategy. It is used when you are thinking that the Nifty will have a very limited increase in the price, very limited increase in the price until expiry. So it's not going to go really volatile up and down, things like that. So this strategy is for very limited movement of the Nifty. So in this strategy, what you do is I'm taking an example of 12,000. strike price and 12,200 strike price. Now, as you can see from the figure there, 12,000 is in the money right now and 12,200 is out of the money. So we buy one lot at the lower strike price, means in the money. We are taking example of 12,000, and we sell one lot at the higher strike price, that is 12,200, that is out of the money. Okay, so now if you see the green part there, I'm saying that because you are buying one lot at a lower strike price in the money, so that is 120 rupees we are paying as a premium, and at the same time we are selling one lot at 12,200. It means that it is like 200 points difference between buy and sell. And we are selling one lot, and the margin of and the premium of that is 28 rupees 25 paise. So now we got the premium. We paid the premium of 120 rupees 50 paise. At the same time, we got the premium of 28 rupees 50 paise. So the overall money that you have paid is 120.58 minus 28.25, that is 92.25 rupees. So 92.25 is going to be the maximum loss that you can incur in this setup. And the difference between these two strike prices is 200, that is 12,200 minus 12,000. So 200 minus whatever you have paid initially, that is 92.25. So the remaining is 107.75. So 107 rupees and 75 paise is the maximum profit you can get out of this. Okay, now we are going to, so the way I'm explaining in this slide is, first, in the first slide I'm teaching what we are trying to do, and in the second slide we are going to go into if then else statements kind of thing. If the market is here, what will happen? If the market is here, what will happen, and things like that. So for this slide, just observe what I'm trying to say here is that we are doing a call side vertical spread with the strike price of 12,000. We are buying one lot at 12,000, which is in the money, and we are selling one lot, that is 12,200, which is out of the money. And we are in the buy, we are paying the premium of 120 rupees 50 paise, and we are getting the premium of 28.25 in the case of sell. So the overall money that you are actually giving out is 92.25, that is your maximum loss, and 200 rupees, that is the width of the spread, that minus whatever you have paid is going to be your maximum profit. Okay, let's go into the next slide. Now in this next slide, this is the slide I have named it as bull call spread profit and loss. The bull call spread is an option strategy designed to benefit from Nifty's limited increase in price, and now on the left side top corner, I'm explaining the trade over there. So the one buy lot is 12,000 at 120.50, one sell lot, it is 12,200, and you have seen that. So maximum loss you are going to incur is 92 rupees and 25 paise. Maximum profit you are going to get is 107 rupees 75 paise, and your break-even point is going to be your lower strike price, that is 12,000, plus whatever amount you have given away. You have given away 92 rupees, so your break-even point is going to be 12,092.25. okay, now if the market closes below this break-even point, then you are going to make loss, and if the market closes above this break-even point, then you are going to make profit. And we are going to, so here I am taking the four kind of examples, point A, point B, point C, and point D. Now in point A, I am assuming that the market is basically Closed at market has basically closed at 11,930. Now this point is below the lower strike price. Okay. Now since 11,930 is less than the lower strike price, then both the contracts will be out of the money, and they both the will be worthless. So their value will be zero, and that's why the total loss is going to be 92 rupees 25 paise. Now, say for example, if the market is between the lower strike price and your break-even point. So here I am taking the example that assuming that the market is closing at 12,056. So in that case, it is lower than the break-even point. So your break-even point is 12,092.25. So if the market is closing at 12,056, then you are going to get the profit or your maximum loss. Let's say that it will be break-even point minus where the market is traded at. So you are going to be like 12,092.25 minus 12,056, that is 36.25. So your loss is going to be 36.25. Okay. Now, if assuming that the market is closing at 12,127. Now 12,127, it is more than your break-even point, so you are going to make little bit of profit here. So how much profit that we are going to see? So the buy contract, now in this situation what will happen is the buy contract will be in the money. Okay, buy contract will be in the money and sell contract will be out of the money. Sell contract will be still out of the money. So in this case, what will happen is the sell contract will be worthless, but you'll get a marginal profit of 12,127 minus your break-even point, that is 12,092.25. So you are going to get the profit of 34 rupees and 75 paise. Okay. Now if the market is above the upper strike price, it is above 12,200. So here in the in this example, I am assuming that the market is above 12,268. Now 12,268 meaning that all the contracts are now in the money. All the contracts are in the money. So your max profit is going to be the spread. The spread is 200 points, the width, spread width is 200 points, 12,200 minus 12,000. So 200 minus whatever money you had paid initially, that is 92 rupees and 25 paise. So the maximum profit you are going to get is 107.75. So in this bull spread, bull call spread, you are going to have a very fixed profit and very fixed loss, maximum profit. So you can actually use this strategy when you don't want to take very big risk, or you have to you want to take the risk only about the your definite risk. So you don't want to sit on the unlimited risk or something. So you, whenever you open the trade, you already know how much maximum risk you are going to get and how much maximum profit you are going to get. So it is a capped risk and capped profit kind of strategy. Okay, moving on to the next slide. Now this is call, bear call spread. Now there are four flavors in this vertical spread. First flavor we already saw, bull call spread. Second one is bear call spread. Then third one will be bull put spread and bear put spread. So it's really very simple. So there are four kind of strategies available. Now this is the second option, second this thing. Now in this what happens is it is exactly same as the before one, but in this we are selling the in the money call and we are buying the out of the money call. It is exactly opposite of what we did in the previous slide, right? Now in this what we are doing is we are selling at 120 rupees.50 paise and we are buying it back. We are buying it at 12,000, that is 28.25. okay. Now and the market is trading at say 12,123, just hypothetical figure, right? So the maximum profit you are going to get is 92 rupees 25 paise, and the maximum loss you are going to incur is width minus whatever you have got before. So width is 200, 12,200 minus 12,000, and that is the width, and the money you have got initially is 92.25 paise. So and maximum loss you can make is 107.75. Okay, let's move. So this bear call spread is a strategy that collects option premium and limits the risk at the same time. So they profit from both time decay and the falling Nifty prices. Now bear call spread profit and loss. So again, here it is the same thing. The main advantage of bear call spread is that the net risk of the trade is reduced, and purchasing a call option with the higher strike price helps offset the risk of the call option at the lower strike price, right? So we are selling one lot at 12,000 and we are buying at 12,200, and there are respective premiums there. And here also I'm assuming that if the market is closing at point A, point B, point C and point D at a different market rates, and I have written in the green boxes there, if the market closes at 11,930, then you are going to make total profit of 92 rupees and 25 paise, because both the options, both the contracts will be worthless here, and whatever money you had got initially as a, that you can keep it as a profit. Okay, now the second one, second example, point B is 12,056. In this situation, you are going to get the profit of maximum 36.25 rupees. You can see the calculations there. It is BEP, that is BEP as 12,092.25 minus wherever the market has closed. Now in the third situation, C, point C, we are assuming that this point is below the upper strike price. Upper strike price is 12,200. So, and here point C is 12,127. So if the market is at 12,127, then your maximum loss is going to be the market trading at 127 minus the break-even point. That is, so maximum loss, the loss that you are going to incur in this situation is 34.75 rupees. Now if the market closes above the upper strike price, no matter how much up it goes, say for example it goes up to 12,500, 12,800 or whatever, in that case also your maximum loss is going to be your width, that is 200 minus whatever money you had got initially. So the maximum loss is going to be 107 rupees and 75 paise. Moving on to the next slide. I know this is this might sound really very difficult and very confusing to you, and yes, it is difficult and confusing. It took me really a lot of time to, you know, get my head together. You know, our mind, when we are doing the trading, our mind is usually set for maybe one trade and two trades and something like that. Plus, there are a lot of variables, right? If it is one trade, then market going up, going down. If it is put side, it is call side, and then it's a lot of confusion. And now we are adding to that confusion, we are multiplying that whole thing by two times. And one is at call side, one is at put side. It's like really a lot of work, you know. But once you understand this properly, you know, trust me that you are going to like it. But it has to, you know, it will come through habit. It doesn't come initially because it's really very confusing, and you are going to make a lot of mistakes when you are trying to implement these strategies, because they are very advanced strategies. Very shrewd traders use this, and it is it has to be used with extreme care. Okay, so let's moving on. I'm not trying to you know, scare you or something, but this is really the fact that it is very confusing, and you need to spend really lot of time to make this presentation. I spent almost a week whenever I had time to make this presentation and to make sure that whatever values or whatever I'm saying in this video, it's not incorrect and it doesn't have any error or something. I have checked it thrice and all the figures and everything. So this whatever information I'm sharing in this video is really very accurate, as much as I can say. May God be my witness. Okay, so let's go to the bull put spread. Now, bull put spread is an option strategy that is used when you expect a moderate rise in the price of an underlying asset, that is Nifty here. So now in this example, we are taking whatever we did on the call side in last two slides, we are doing it on the put side now. And again, we are using the same examples and same strike prices, but in this case, the premiums are going to be different. If you can see that the premium for 12,200 is 146.50 and the premium for 12,000 is 38 rupees and 80 paise. Okay, now you are buying one lot which is out of the money, that is at 12,000, and you are selling one lot, that is 12,200, which is in the money, and your break even point is again going to be same, 12,092.30. Moving on to the next slide. Now here I am not taking the profit loss statements. I'm not making this slide because I want to give you a homework that you try to work out these figures based on. It's really that easy. So what you have to do is you have to first just think about only one trade first, and then think about the other trade, and then add them together, and then see how the profit loss matches or something. Now in this case, it's really very simple. First we do is we buy at the bull put spread. You buy one lot at in the money, out of the money, and you sell one lot in the money. Okay. Now next one, bear put spread. Now in bear put spread, we are doing exactly opposite of what we did in the previous slide. In this, what you do is you sell at the out of the money call. You set the sell the out of the money put, that is at 12,200, and you buy out in the money one contract which is at 12,200, and the price of that is 146.50. Now in this you'll get maximum profit of 107.70 and you are going to get maximum loss of 92.30. So I want to give you an homework, like how do you find out this break even points in this, and how can you find out the in the previous examples I had taken point A, point B, point C, point D in the call side. So try to figure it out, take the same strike prices and try to figure it out. If the market closes at point A, what will happen? If market closes to point B, what will happen? And so on and so forth. So in this way you are going to learn a lot, and that's about it for this vertical spread video. Thank you very much for spending your time in learning about this. This is going to be really very difficult, and a lot of your patience are going to be checked. So please pay a lot of attention to this. I'm going to upload this presentation on my website www.theindianoptions.com. Please log in over there and register yourself and download this PDF from there. And when you're watching this video, just keep this PDF handy so that you'll be able to see this properly. And that's about it. Thank you very much, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. The subscription button is right here. Thank you very much, and you have a nice day. Bye bye.